We will now discuss the solution of a problem from the section analysis, and the problem is based on the properties of continuous functions, and this question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section B. The problem is, let f be a non-constant polynomial of degree k, and let g be a function from R to R, where R is the set of all real numbers, be a bounded continuous function. Which of the following statements is necessarily true? We are given four options. Option 1, there always exists x0 belongs to R such that f of x0 is equal to g of x0. Option 2, there is no x0 belongs to R such that f of x0 is equal to g of x0. Option 3, there always exists x0 belongs to R such that f of x0 is equal to g of x0 if k is even. Option 4, there always exists x0 belongs to R such that f of x0 is equal to g of x0 if k is odd. We'll now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. We are given f a non-constant polynomial of degree k, and we are also given a function g from R to R, and it is a bounded continuous function. We know every polynomial is a continuous function, and f is continuous, g is continuous, f minus g is also a continuous function from R to R. You have to note down that g is a bounded function, and you have to note down f is a non-constant polynomial of degree k. Now, if f minus g of y and f minus g of z have opposite signs, then by the intermediate value theorem, there exists an element x0 between y and z such that f minus g of x0 is equal to 0, and that is f of x0 is equal to g of x0. We will use this result to establish some of the results given above. Case 1, let k be odd, k is odd. Since k is odd and g is bounded, limit extends to infinity of f of f minus g of x is plus infinity, and limit extends to minus infinity of f of f minus g of x is minus infinity. This is true because k is odd and the leading coefficient of f is positive. When the leading coefficient of f is positive and k is odd, limit extends to infinity is plus infinity. When k is odd and the leading coefficient of f is positive, then limit extends to minus infinity of f minus g of x is minus infinity. And if the leading coefficient of f is negative and k is odd, then these limits will be get reversed. Limit extends to infinity of f minus g of x is minus infinity when k is odd and the leading coefficient of f is negative, and limit extends to minus infinity of f minus g of x is plus infinity if the degree k is odd and the leading coefficient of f is negative. Therefore, they have the opposite signs. They have the opposite signs. By the intermediate value theorem, there exists an element x0 belongs to R such that f minus g of x naught is equal to 0, that is f of x naught is equal to g of x naught. So in this case, we have an element here. So let's look at the options. Option 2 says there is no x naught belongs to R such that f of x naught is equal to g of x naught. This is not true, because when k is odd and there always exists an x naught belongs to R such that f of x naught is equal to g of x naught if k is odd. That is, so that means the option 4 is true and the option 2 is not true. So let's move to the next case is case 2. Let us take k be even. Let, and we give a counter example, let f of x is equal to x square and g of x is equal to minus c, where c is greater than 0. That means g of x is minus c, negative. For all x, it is minus c. Now, f minus g of x will be f of x square minus g of x, that is minus into minus of minus c, that is plus c, where c is greater than 0. So for all x belongs to R, x square plus c will be positive. Therefore, the graph of f minus g will not cross the x-axis. So therefore, there is no x naught belongs to R such that f minus g of x naught is equal to 0. That is, f of x naught is equal to g of x naught. So look at the options. Option 1 says there always exists x naught belongs to R such that f of x naught is equal to g of x naught, which is not true. And in this case, it is not. And there always exists x naught belongs to R such that f of x naught is equal to g of x naught if k is even. It is not true. So when k is even, here is a counter example. There is no x naught belongs to R such that f of x naught is equal to g of x naught. Thus, the options 1 and 3 are not true. So our final answer is option 4 is true. So that is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the analysis, and the problem is based on the properties of continuous functions. I hope that you have understood the argument of the proof, and go on working out some more problems on the properties of continuous functions. I wish you all the best. Thank you.